Not everyone looks for the greatest, but most are interested for the latest. Intel's B360 chipset was designed for those consumers. There's also a growing need for making one's own PC look nice. The MSI Mortar Titanium was built for that purpose. Previously a premium color for the higher-end motherboards, the Mortar Titanium is a beauty to behold. There is an uptrend in building a gunmetal rig, and the Titanium is MSI's offering to gamers who are not looking into buying a Z370 motherboard. MSI has built up what it started from the B150 up to the B250 offering. The heatsink for the VRMs look noticeably bigger and wider. This move to increase the cooling capacity of the VRMs would make sense since Intel has increased the number of cores for the Coffee Lake lineup. Another noticeable difference is the placement of the SATA ports, which I really love. Previously, we were presented with just these vertically aligned ports. MSI has graciously given builders the chance to be flexible by providing two SATA ports in a 90-degree orientation. The rest are standard mortar goodness that we've been accustomed to, such as the generous number of system fan ports, two PCIe slots, of which one is reinforced, and the red and black colored gaming ports. However, I think it would have been a nice touch if these ports were somewhat gunmetal colored too. Then again, this is something that isn't seen whenever you display your PC, so all is well. The selling point of the B360 is for people who are not looking into overclocking. With this in mind, we entered the benchmarks comparing the stock i5-8600K performance if it were paired with either the B360 or the Z370. First off is the POV Ray single and multi-threaded performance. In the single-thread performance, the Z370 only leads by about 0.7 seconds. We see a similar performance when it comes to the multi-threaded tests. The Z370 only leads by about 0.8 seconds. These are very negligible differences and may be attributed to variance. Now we move on to the Cinebench R15 benchmark. Similarly, the Z370 only gains a bit of performance against the B360. The small difference will not be felt by most users during their day-to-day use of their gaming PCs. Lastly, we use Blender's BMW benchmark to cap things off. Again, the Z370 only leads a small amount, making it conclusive that the Z370 and the B360's only performance difference will come to life if you do have a chip that can be overclocked. With the number shown earlier, the B360 is your best bet if you don't plan to buy the unlocked coffees. On with the gaming benchmarks. For this test, we use a GTX 1060 and 16GB of DDR4 RAM running at 2400 MHz. The first game is Doom, where we experience smooth gameplay all throughout. The minimum frames are well above the 60fps golden frame rate. For MOBA, we run Dota 2. Frames are also above the 60fps acceptable rates, resulting to buttery smooth gameplay. In conclusion, the B360 Mortar Titanium is an amazing combination of performance and budget. The gunmetal theme is something that is making waves with builders and gamers alike. If you're like me and you were enticed to build a gunmetal gaming rig, hit that share or like button. Thanks for watching and see you next time.